And I was running behind this fan screaming, "Wait, wait, you have to help me because my plant is lost." I ordered this plant online and I was very excited about it. I was looking forward to it arriving in the mail. And it has been quite a while since I ordered anything online. I think the last time I ordered plants, they were the little baby plants that I showed you in my video, Meet My New Baby Plants. They tried to deliver it at my home, but I was not there. And then I received the email of the postal service telling me that they brought it to a pickup point. And this pickup point is actually very close by, so I was thinking that's not a problem. I will go over there, I'm going to collect my plant, and then everything is going to be okay. It was raining all day, but I was thinking, you know what, I should hop on my bike, go over there, collect this plant and bring it home, because I really need to take this plant out of the box. So this man opened the door and I could look into his home, and let me tell you, this was the biggest mess I have ever seen. There were dishes everywhere, dirty laundry on the floor, the boxes were just piled up sky high. It was complete chaos. So I told the man, "I am here to collect my plant. Can you please find it for me?" And he started to look for my plant, but he was not checking the names on the boxes. He was just picking up boxes and then he would shake them and then he would tell me, "I do not think that this is a plant," and then he would throw it away, and then he would pick up another box and then he would shake it, and then he would tell me, "I do not think that this is a plant either," and then he would throw it away. And I was getting a little bit nervous and I told him, "You know what, maybe it's not such a good idea to shake all of these boxes, because you do not know what's in it. It could be fragile. Just check for the name and see if you can find my plant that way." And in the meanwhile, I was standing outside in the pouring rain, I think for about 20 minutes. And then I saw the postal delivery guy. He came driving in his van, and I was running behind this van screaming, "Wait, wait, you have to help me because my plant is lost." So I asked him, "Can you please check for me if you delivered my plant to this pickup point?" And he checked and he told me it should definitely be here. So just tell this man to keep looking. So I went back to the door and I told the man, "Please keep looking for my plant." And he just kept telling me, "I do not have it, I do not have it." And I just kept telling him, "Just keep looking, keep looking." Then this other man came walking up to me with a phone in his hand and he asked me, "Did you also lose something? Because I just tried to collect something here and they told me they do not have it. And I just tried to call the postal service, but they just hang up on me." So then I was thinking, you know what? This is not going so well. I went home without my plant, a little bit disappointed. And the next morning I emailed the plant shop and they did a little bit of research for me. And I also called the postal service and they said, "You just need to go back there and ask this man to look for your plant again." So this is exactly what I'm going to do right now. I'm going to hop on my bike. I'm going to go over there and I'm going to ask him to look for my plant again, and I really hope that he is going to find it, and then I can bring it home and then we can do a nice little unboxing and we will all be very happy. happy. That actually went quite well, better than expected. I'm very happy that I found my plant and I'm dying to open this box. I really hope it's okay. But first I want to take a little bit of time to talk to you about the shop where I ordered this plant. So this shop is called Kekjeki. It is a shop located in the Netherlands. The name is a little bit strange because the translation for Kekjeki is cool jacket. I do not really know how they came up with that name, but it is a very nice shop. And the first thing I want to say is that this plant getting missing in the mail is definitely not their fault. So I want to clarify that. When I emailed them about my plant that got missing in the mail, they replied very quickly and they were very nice and very helpful. They contacted the postal office for me and I was very happy with the customer service. I ordered plants from them before and they always arrived very quickly and in very good shape. So I really hope that this plant is going to be okay. And I also will link their YouTube channel below so you can take a look. And I also want to link another video. And this video is made by Yoga and Plants with Rose. And this is actually a Dutch YouTube channel, but it is in English. It is very, it's a very nice channel to check out. And she also made a video about Kekjeki and she made a little tour around the office that they have all their plants in, and they did a little interview with the people that run this shop. And it is actually quite a nice video to watch. You can see all of their plants and hear a little bit of the background story of this shop. So I will also link that video down below so you can take a look. And now I suggest that we are going to open this box. I'm well armed and I have to be honest, I cannot even remember the name of this plant. The only thing that I can remember is that I wanted to order this for quite a while and I never did until last week. So let's open it. Probably there will be a note in it, in this box telling me what I exactly ordered. So let's take a look. Ooh, some packing paper. There's also a little stick attached to the plant. That's also very nice when they do that to prevent anything from moving around in the box. Please be okay. It looks quite well. It looks thirsty, but okay. So are you curious already? Do you want me to show you this plant? So this is it. Let's see first what the note is saying, because probably it will tell me the name of this plant. I feel quite horrible not remembering it. But yeah, shit happens. Thank you so much for ordering. Oh, they write something about their story. Hi there, we are Thijs and Nina and we are the faces behind Kekjeki. As you might have guessed already, we are completely obsessed with plants. Like me. All species, all sizes, our mission is to share our love of plants with the world. We sell a great variety of plants in our webshop, ranging from adorable plug plants to incredible rare plants. Each one is handpicked by us ensuring only the best quality. Hopefully you will love our plants as much as we do. That's nice, isn't it? A cute little card. Invoice, okay, well, let's take a look. Oh yes, Epipremnum Amplissimum. Epipremnum Amplissimum. That's what I ordered. So let me show you a close-up of this plant for a minute. I think it actually looks quite well. I am going to give it a little bit of water, of course, and a little bit of love and attention, and some fertilizer probably also. And I need to find a nice pot for it, so maybe I will go to the thrift store. I was already planning to do that anyway, to see if I can find anything to put this plant in. And I think it's very beautiful. I really like the long shape of the leaves. I do not have a lot of plants that have this shape, and I really like to have different textures in different areas in my house. So I'm very, very happy with this plant. I think it looks absolutely gorgeous. I think it would like to have something to climb on, so I need to do a little bit of thinking about that. But besides that, I think we have a success. So they taped the top of the pot completely, and there's actually no soil in the box whatsoever. So that's quite impressive. I think I'm going to go to the thrift store. I actually have a store like that in my street. It's about a 5-minute walk. They do not like people filming there, so I cannot bring you along. That's a little bit of a shame, but if I find a nice spot for it, I will show it to you. And also, of course, I need to find a place in my home for this plant where it can grow happily ever after. Just came back from the thrift store, could not find anything for my plant. And then I did a search all around my house, and I found one more terracotta pot. This is really the last one. I do have a few in the garden though, so I should really go there and collect those. But even though this is a little bit more narrow, it is also a little bit higher, so I think I can squeeze it in. For now, I'm going to keep it on this little table over here. This is not where it is going to stay. I am going to find a different place for it, but this is where it's going to be for the next couple of days. I'm also going to put it on a bamboo stick, because I really think this plant would love something to climb on. And I found a nice green ceramic saucer, do you call it a saucer, to put underneath this pot. And I think then we will be all settled in for now. Oh gee, that just happened. Wow. Oh my god. I'm so clumsy. Well, I guess putting this in a different pot is not such a bad idea after all. Okay, let's see what we can do here. Oh gee. You know, stuff like this always happens to me. The root system looks very nice. It's not root bound at all, but it looks very healthy. I'm just going to use the soil that it came in. Maybe I need to add a little. Just have to see. Oh, this poor plant. I'm sorry. Did not do that on purpose. You know, I just cleaned up from my last video. Do not know if you have seen that, but I made a huge mess on my floor with soil. And this feels like déjà vu. I was really planning to keep it a little bit more tidy this time. Guess that did not happen. Okay, I think it's okay. First, I'm going to give it a very good soak. I'm going to put it in this bowl. Let me show this to you. It's actually very pretty. It's French. I bought this at a flea market for, I think, 1.50 euro and 50 cents. It's really lovely. I'm just going to put this plant in here because I really want to water this well. I did put a little bit of fertilizer in here. I fertilize my plants every week, but I do not give them the normal amount. I just give them a tiny little bit, and they all seem to be very happy with that. Let's see if I can get in the bamboo stick. So that was it for this week's video. I'm so happy that I found my plant. I really hope that you enjoyed watching this video. If you want to see more of these videos, please subscribe to my channel, and then I will see you in the next one. Bye!